15 minutes. Maybe more than you. Get you a head start.
Thank you very much. We appreciate this opportunity to tell you a little bit about our firm. Both the children on our credentials, they would leave like to work for. I'm Jim Ingram. I'm the senior principal of GUA Architects in Valdosta. I've got two fellows with me today. The three of us will make up the team that produce your work if you choose to give it to us. I'll be the project the principal in charge. Jason Gregory will be the project manager, and this job will have a fair amount of civil engineering on it. We have a plate building from local associates that'll be civil engineering. You'll hear from them as we go along. GUA is a firm of right now 14 people in Valdosta. I personally have been in business in Valdosta for 50 years now. Starting in 1965, actually. And I've been in continuous business all that time through a number of different partnerships and business associations. The team that we've got that make up Studio 8 Design has been built over a period of about 30 years. Bill Booth is one of the eight original, or the eight owners of Studio 8, has been with me 33 years now, I think so. And the youngest one of the eight has been with me 10 years. So it's not, our firm as Studio 8 is fairly new, but it's not a new group. We've got lots of experience working together. We do a lot of government projects, and we'd like to include the other cities amongst those clients. That's our offices there on that slide. I'm going to give you a little bit of information about our overall experience. A number of years ago, in fact, several decades ago now, I was the architect for the Perry Ag Center in Fairground. That facility has everything, all the elements that you will have on this site that you're looking at. It's a different scale, but maybe your honeybee scale or your honeybee festival will look like that to you, right? We've got a project in Bullitt County over Statesboro. It's a sports facility in some place. Got a lot of site work and different venues. Over the years, we've done a lot of municipal buildings. I know we're talking about a park here, but it'll have some shelters and structures on it, and it'll have a relationship to municipal buildings that might be. Some of them might be built on it. I don't know exactly what your plans, but the pertinent thing here is we know about municipal buildings. We've designed a bunch of them, of different things that American Public Safety building just finished last year. We've done fire stations around it. Parts on the left and state in Fayetteville. And we've also done a couple of buildings in AI, so we're not new to the area. In fact, Jason and I have higher addresses, and so we look forward to working here in our home today. The other building, we changed it just a number of years ago, always. That's another piece of working in Hayhower. Mr. Clayton.
Good afternoon. I'm Clayton Milligan, and we'll be handling the civil design portion in conjunction with Chase and Mr. Ingram. For design this part. We recently were awarded a very similar type of project with the Lowndes County Parks and Rec Authority. We'll be designing the new Freedom Park expansion. They're adding some new softball fields along with the Miracle League field, which has some very specific design criteria, a lot of hardscape, similar type elements that would be out here. We've also, along with that project, the Maxi Park expansion, they're adding several new tennis courts to the Maxi Park facility. There'll be some gazebos associated with that, hardscape, green space, landscaping. So a lot of the same elements that we're be dealing with here, we're already teamed up with Studio 8 on this project over for the Parks and Rec Authority. These facilities will have public restrooms, outdoor public restrooms, very similar to this. We're dealing with stormwater management, the the Freedom Park facility has a large drainage canal running right through where the fields are going, so we're going to have to figure out how to deal with that. I understand there's not through phase one, but when phase one is designed, the drainage needs to be considered for this project because you have a large drainage ditch that runs through the phase two portion. So we'll need to take that into account with our layout, with our design. We've worked on many other products at Studio 8, so we have a good working relationship with them. Some other experience that we have in dealing with the same type of project, being right on Highway 122, we'll have to deal with permitting with Georgia DOT. We've done numerous projects dealing with the District 4 office and all the ins and outs of getting the permits that we need to for access and parking, as we might look at reviewing some of that. Also, this project has a unique aspect of being adjacent to the rail, and this isn't just any rail. We've actually gotten three utility crossing permits on a recent project we did to the city of Valdosta. This is a Norfolk Southern line. It's actually, I was told by Norfolk Southern that there's the busiest line in Georgia. It averages 24 trains a day, which is more than any other main line in Georgia. So you got a lot of rail traffic, and they we're going to pay close attention to anything we're doing adjacent to their right-of-way and potentially within their right-of-way. So I understand there's some possibility of trying to get some access roads paved actually just inside the right-of-way, potentially to help with honeybee traffic and any other events that are going on at certain times. Also, stormwater management, is one of the big pieces of the puzzle that civil engineer brings to the table. We did the civil design for the new Dollar General store, which is right down the street here, so we're familiar with drainage in Kahira, and I think our experience there will help us with this project as well. We've got landscape design. Obviously, this will be a park green space area. We'll be seeking to do some low maintenance. Landscaping doesn't require a lot of ongoing maintenance, low water use, but still look good and bring a lot of aesthetic qualities to this park. And then you got hardscape design. So your sidewalk layout, most of this space will be hardscape. You'll have the event, the bandstand portion, public restrooms, and all that's going to be connected with the hardscape. We were actually part of, I don't think any of y'all had a chance to go out to Moody Air Force Base and see the President George W. Bush Heritage Park. We were actually the civil designers on that particular park with the static display aircraft out there in front of the headquarters building at Moody Air Force Base. So we were part of the hardscape design on that. And also the VSU Health Science Building downtown with VSU. We did the civil design for that building. So they have a lot of good green space and public use areas around their buildings. Some of the projects that we've been involved with. We've also done many sidewalk improvements and new sidewalk projects in the city of Valdosta and some of their sidewalk improvement plans. I think Chase is going to speak to this some, but just, my personal experience with the Hayhire area, I've had lived here for 8 years. I'm, used to kidding right down the street and talk to Mr. Bruce. But it's like we use this building, we go to church at Northbridge, so we're up here all the time, so I have a personal knowledge of what that area is used for, some of the challenges of that area. I've got little kids, so keeping that in mind, how we can best design the space to be a good space for kids, for events, for honeybee festivals, for smaller events, and Chase can speak more to that.
Well, I'm Chase Mary Green, and it's good to be back here with you. Clayton and Mr. Ingram have done a good job giving an overview of our qualifications professionally, and what I'd like to do is just take a few minutes, like Clayton said, and talk about personal involvement in the community. On this particular project, it was about 5 years ago that I was working with the city, and I was working with Mr. Glenn Gregory at the time. So we were developing a plan because the city knew they had the foresight to know that they needed to have a plan. And so we worked at that time. It was really two things. It was a site acquisition, land acquisition, as well as land utilization. And there were some constraints and hurdles at the time that we had to consider. But we did that, and we put together a framework, put together a concept and a budget and a likely schedule and a phasing strategy, knowing that over the years, whether it was a few years or a lot of years, that was something that you could build on, that it could be modified or adjusted. My actual personal involvement in Hayhart spans a lot more years than that. I was a Hayhart junior high Tiger, if anybody remembers the Tigers. And little did I know back then that I was going to one day be raised four kids in the same community, and so the parade that I participated in, I was going to be pulling floats, so I was going to be out in the sunshine at the bandstand, watching presentations or building strand guns at the old Craigman Foundations, and all those types of things. Plus, I mean, you want to see pictures of my kids anyway. But I really, that is what this type of project is all about. It is about how Hayhart uses the property and has used it for years. And it's about making it available for the type of things we like to do and possibly some of the things we haven't done yet. I mean, when we're out there and we feel the crush of crowds now at Honeybee Festival compared to what it used to be, or we're at a third Thursday movie night or whatever it may be, those are the types of things that inform me professionally. It's not theoretical for me. You know, I've lived it, and I really had the same desire and the same heartbeat on this property. But looking forward from that, again, looking at the phasing strategy that was put in place, and I commend the city on being able to acquire the land, and not only that, but we don't have the constraints that we originally thought we had with closing Lawson Street at the railroad track, and that's a big benefit. And we can still do that. We still have control of it. We can put removable bollards or whatever we want to do, so that at such time that we need to control Lawson Street for events or anything that nature, we can. But the rest of the time, the bank, the church, the rest of the citizens, the circulating, it's easy to do because Lawson Street is still open and it provides good access to really use this site. In a way that previously we didn't think might have been possible. But some of these other projects on the side, within our office, we've got different people. We worked on projects from Deer Park, Chicago, which I didn't know there were deer in Chicago, I guess there are, all the way to Fort Myers, Florida. And even though the types of projects are a little different, but the needs are still the same. For a project to be inviting, for it to be aesthetically pleasing, for it to be secure for people, to have really a pedestrian environment so people are comfortable. All those types of things from these other projects help inform us so that our role in working with you really is to ask the right questions, to bring up possibilities, and coming to the right conclusion of how we want to use this property. And of course, we need to update the utilization of this site, because we have the opportunity to do so by the changes at Lawson Street. But so we've looked at that. I can't help but think of it every day because I drive by it multiple times every day. But it is important to make sure that this site meets the needs of the community and really represents not just our residents, but our businesses and our visitors, because we want them to have the same feeling when they come to Hayhart. You know, basically it's a place where you're never afraid to say hello to somebody. It's kind of the way I look at it. And we want people to always feel that way. But the process for us, for our team, with you, is actually, in a nutshell, it's pretty simple. We see ourselves as coming on board for a limited time as, in effect, an extension of your staff. We just happen to have particular expertise and abilities in areas to help meet the goals that are established by the city council or by the community or the DDA or whatever process that's in place. We just want to plug into that and work with you so that whether it's phase one. I almost feel like phase one is behind us already, but establishing this phase two, you know, the best way to get to phase three is for us to make the decisions and do the right things in phase two. And then phase three, whenever it is, whenever it comes online, whatever it becomes, it's easier to get there. But it's difficult to get to phase two or phase three if we don't take the time to really evaluate and make the right decisions now. But we're confident. Worked with you before in the past. You've got talented people here and on your development authority. And I know the heart of people in the town as well. And I'm confident that together that we can arrive at the correct solution as we move ahead. And I do thank you for being able to be with you again today.
And thank you.
You have
a question for City LA? All right.
If there are no questions, we appreciate this opportunity and hope you'll allow us to work with you. We would like to be your architect. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.